Yeah, Roland's trying. He is, because he from an AI's perspective. Now remember, Roland is post Cortana AI, so okay he is as human in a way with emotions as Cortana was.
Every target is just another target.
Button. And so he is trying to look at it from an AI's perspective. Cortana, he like he said, what? Yeah, because she didn't die when she was supposed to. You guys want to abandon her and kill her? So there's a level of Roland maybe wondering what his future is should he experience rampancy. And also the hope that Cortana being alive gives him, meaning that she can live past rampancy, maybe he could too.
The hell?
So I really liked, Roland. I liked, they gave him a lot of personality in this one. AI perspective is bae. Roland is bae. John Malee says,
short circuit their suit systems.
Yeah, new weapon device. It's pretty awesome. Shuts enemies down. Pretty sweet stuff.
They're locked.
And the reason they have this scene here is because in the original draft, Spartan Locke, who was named Smith.
Every soldier, when they hear about this, they're going to hate us.
Sorry, I had to hear that line. Right?
You're not the only one here because of him.
I love that little exchange. So originally here, there was a scene written where they were both in here exchanging war stories and picking up weapons. And there was like a Q type person. Because originally Spartan Locke was based off of James Bond. They wanted a James Bond type guy to come in who was a little bit more sophisticated, a little bit more debonair, a little bit more charming than Master Chief. The complete opposite of Master Chief, but still capable. So that's why that scene takes place there and they introduce the new weapon there. Was because some of that is left over from that original draft. No, you have an AI thing. I don't have an AI thing. Yeah. Well, you said Roland is bae, so I was just quoting you. But you heard that line there. They're being assigned to go trace the information and the contacts they're getting from Cortana. Osiris' team is being issued to do it. And we're taking the express elevator down.
Tend to see it as an act of aggression.
Check this out.
Speaking of acts of
pretty awesome.
Those are Forerunner ships.
But we're being sent to get her as Osiris. Yeah, once Chief learned that it was her and that she was heading to Meridian, that's Cortana obviously trying to reach out to Chief too, saying, look, if there is something going on, if I am here, there's something wrong with me, you need to bring me in. Halsey doesn't think Master Chief can be, you know, like she thinks he'll be biased when he comes across her. He'll give her the benefit of the doubt. And according to Halsey, from her experience of what AIs do, she's willing to, you know, she basically doesn't think Cortana can be Cortana, still be, you know, still be her and be reached. And of course she would think that. She steals children and turns them into super soldiers. So you could tell Halsey's level of hope and stuff hasn't really changed. Even though she believes John is more man than machine, and she said so in the previous game, because she believes that, she knows Master Chief will ultimately make the choice that she doesn't believe in this particular situation. So now the Osiris team has been sent to get to Meridian before Master Chief, and if they encounter Chief, to prevent him from doing anything. In contacting Cortana. And like Buck said, hey, look, when everyone finds out about this, and they will, when they find out we've been sent to stand in Master Chief's way, we are going to be the biggest assholes in the UNSC. And Spartan Locke's like, look, man, you're not the only person who is alive today because of Master Chief. Spartan Locke actually owes some of his backstory to Master Chief as well. So Spartan Locke isn't just a machine, although he does follow orders and listens very well to orders. He's gonna come to a moment as well, a moment of crisis in this game as well, and he's gonna have to make a choice, and whether he chooses a choice similar to Master Chief's or something different, something more destructive, is something we'll play out in this game. So it's definitely going to be a fun little journey there with that character as well. John Wick says, dude, this is so fucking cool. Or again, I may have a thing about AI. You're totally okay to have feelings for an artificial intelligence. Lord knows I do. Alright. Yeah, this, and look at these games. Like, that's one of the things I like about this game too, is you actually go on a couple different planets and locations in this game. Which normally I don't like when things open up that way. And I feel like because they do that, you do get some issues with the narrative in this being like kind of weak. But one planet we get to go to in this game is the Sangili homeworld. We are going to get to see an old friend of ours, or at least an old friend of the Master Chief's. See, do you prefer the gunplay with the Promethean weapons from Halo 4? Yes, I do. You'll probably notice I pick them up a lot. I am trying to be cognizant of not always using them, so that way you guys can see at least a variety of weapons in my playthrough. So I'm trying, but yeah, I do favor them. I really like them from a design standpoint, and I find them to be pretty effective. And if you have shitty aim, like I do, they make up for that as well, a little bit.
Night Commander, just showed up with reinforcements.
So we got a Promethean Knight here. Come on, bitch. Time to be assassinated. These guys look like they're from Cybertron. That's also why I like the Prometheans a little bit. They feel like Transformers to me. I'm a big Transformer fan. I gotta play that Transformer game, actually. They released like a cel-shaded Transformer game. You can sometimes find it for like 20 bucks. I gotta pick that up at some point. It looks like a lot of fun. Halo 4 or 5? Oh, I see. Oh, which do I prefer out of Halo 4 or 5? I'll be honest with you, I haven't played enough of 5 to really form a full opinion on them. 5 is the one I've played the least. Actually, Halo 2 is, because I first played it with the Halo Master Chief Collection. So I've only played through Halo 2 like 3 times. I think I've played through this like 4 or 5 times, but I don't think I have a strong opinion. I would say 4 right now, just to give you that answer. But I do like them in this game too. Sorry, I didn't understand your question. I thought you were just asking if in general I preferred them over other weapons in other games. Ammo. Ooh, you look pretty. How do I get inside you? I'm taking higher ground. Oh, wait. There's like a... Oh, shit. I almost did. I almost... There's a new slam technique that we saw in the opening cutscene. I was just trying to do it, and I messed it up. Because the weapon changed pretty drastically from 4 to 5. Yeah. Yeah, they did. But I didn't, I wouldn't say drastically. Drastically is not the word I would use, anyway, to describe the change. There are a couple new ones. One thing that changes is, like, the alt firing is a lot easier in this one. For me, at least. Are we gonna leave? Because I'd like to... There we go. John says, How do I get inside you? Pro tip, y'all don't leave your computer to get water when Seek is talking. It will leave you confused. Thank you, Balazar. Thank you, John Lee, for the laugh. And thank you, Balazar. That's a... Balazar's cracking up too. Yeah, please don't do that. Don't leave your com- computers unattended. You guys are awesome. I love that the mongooses have weapons on them now, too. Super sweet. Oh, shit. Stay afloat, lady. But yeah, there's definitely, I noticed a difference for sure on the weapons, but they don't feel that, I mean, having just played 4 the other day, that's probably the least jarring switch that I've experienced so far in this game. Because just the controls are different, that sprint jump boost thing.
We can do that, sir.
Being more of a staple. And like a regular feature, as opposed to like a special, like where you can switch it out with turrets and all that other stuff they did in 4. Just some of those features just feel a little jarring and took a while to get used to. Promethean weapons, so far at least, didn't feel like that much of a shift. Felt like a shift, but just not like a major one. Ooh. Yeah, these Promethean soldiers can drive vehicles, just pretty dope. Yeah, like I said, there was a lot of different. What's up, OK Cunning? Welcome to the chat. Okay, Cunning in the house. Okay, Cunning in the house.
Service garage could sure use your help. Well, they might just have a scorpion in there.
They have a tank. Why do they have a
Spacefly? What up, Spacefly? And okay, Cunning. Yay! Oh, I came all the way up here for that? No, thank you. Ooh, y'all dead. Let's go get that scorpion, yo. Go get that scorpion and drive it up them butts. Space Fly and OK Cunning, my best friends, and Jamali, and Dallas and Balazar. Okay, that's awesome. I gotta work on it. It's a work in progress. Three of the four horsemen. That's right. Dallas is still at work, I think. Ooh, you dead. Oh shit, son. Oh, you dead too? Give me that.
Well done, Spartans. Head over to the garage. I'll have Billy open up.
Spartans. Oh, Billy. Holy. Hey, Jom. Okay, Cunning says.
Need to borrow your toy.
What? Ooh.
They'll get more use out of it than you will.
Yes, we will.
Meridian Station's just up the hill.
Oh, this is so sweet, yo.
Why did they have a scorpion? This is UNSC gear.
Corporate security. Private security for a frontier colony isn't unusual. Surprising to see something this heavy, though.
Yeah. Is that a good enough explanation for you? Wait, oh, I'm in the turret. I gotta drive this thing. Yeah, I wanna drive the scorpion. Took it up, yo.
Ready to move.
Well, welcome. We have just started. We're on mission 3, I believe, of Halo 5 Guardians. And we can definitely catch you up on the backstory. Okay, Guinness says, hey, Feet, what up? Everyone who's joining us tonight, thank you so much for being here. Oh, shit. You're feisty. You're feisty. You son of a bitch.
You just hit me, Buck.
That's a kill.
Oops, Zeke still can't drive these things. Hey, guys with guns on the side of my tank, can you shoot things? Thank you. Eat Feet says, hey, Cunning, how are you, buddy? Oh, I love the pink on you, Eat Feet. Good, pal. Just got off work. See ya, pals.
The quick turnaround from get off my planet to, hey, can you help?
Talking to us. That's a start.
Ooh, you look pretty. Let's shoot ya.
Just hold still, crawler.
Ooh. Y'all better run. Oh, snap.
Scorpion's ready to spread some fire.
We get him? Everyone dead who's gonna stay dead? Okay, good. So, just to give OK Cunning and Spacefly a little bit of a recap, we are this game takes place in the year 2558. It's 8 months after Halo 4. Master Chief is kind of, you know, he's a little bit more he's less likely to do a mission nowadays. Like, he gets sent on missions still. He still works for ONI and UNSC and stuff, but he does kind of. No one really, as you know, the others have said, no one really tells him what to do. He's, you know, if he wants to go west, when you tell him to go east, he'll go west. And so what he was doing was he was being sent on a mission to check out this base. Jewel Mudama, who is a rogue covenant, like, asshole, basically, who still hates humanity. He was set up in the Spartan Ops game that takes place at the same time as, or right after Halo 4, and you play that game as Sarah Palmer and her team. And Jewel has kidnapped Halsey and has been torturing her for information, using her to track down remnants of Cortana and other technologies that they can use to improve their fighting ability. Some of that was Promethean technology. Oh shit.
You're up, Buck.
You gotta revive him. Forgot to tell you, Seek Tattoo went well. Decided to go with a skull and a Native American. Dude, are you on Instagram? Are we buddies on Instagram? I think we are, Eatfeet, right? Send me tag me in your picture of it. Oh, no, stop doing that. Here we go. Hey, Buck, stop getting in my way, yo. Oh, shit. Promethean ships. Damn.
Stop shooting the scorpion. I shot one.
But that's awesome, Eatfeet. Very cool, very cool. I can't wait to see it, brother. So, at the beginning of the game, we were introduced to the Osiris team, which is Spartan Locke, Buck, Vale, and Tanaka here. Shit. Come on. Please die. And we were sent in to take down Jewel and rescue Halsey after she's been missing for some time. So we did the first level, got introduced to the Osiris team, Fire Team Osiris here. And then we switched over to Master Chief, and Master Chief was infiltrating a research base. And once we got there, the Covenant and the Prometheans had, you know, sided with each other and are taking over that too. So what we end up doing is, we in a battle against a hunter, we had a vision, and that vision was of Cortana, and so apparently there are still remnants of Cortana out there, and Halsey's been tracking her, trying to find out where she is, and found out that she was, seems to be on the planet Meridian. And then Master Chief had a hallucination. He took a head injury, and hallucinated, or believed maybe hallucinated, or saw a vision of Cortana. and she said to meet her on Meridian. Although we couldn't tell if it was Cortana, it did look like her, even though she looked life-size and human, or like, you know, she didn't look like a digital form. She wasn't like see-through blue when she appeared to Chief. She was like a shadow, a silhouette. So maybe she's still alive. Maybe there's a remnant of her, a spark of her out there that we can salvage. And so we wanted to go and find it. And our team here, Blue Team, which, or this isn't our team, I'm sorry, a Blue Team who is aiding Master Chief, they are on their way to Meridian. And that's where this team is here, Meridian Station. So Master Chief is trying to get here before them, but we beat him here. And now we know that Master Chief is coming. And we've been ordered to stand in his way and prevent him from reaching Cortana by Halsey and the UNSC. So, and once that was revealed, Buck said, look, when everyone finds out about this, when all the other Spartans and the other soldiers find out that we're being sent to stand in Master Chief's way, we're going to be looked down on. Rampancy onset, late stage from the looks. And Spartan Locke is like, yeah, but that's the job, right? And so that's our mission right now, is to go stand in Master Chief's way. Should have gone with a fedora, Spacefly said. Okay, Cunning agrees. Absolutely. So Sloan is like the mayor, governor of this Meridian town. And he's going through rampancy, and he's still the governor of this place.
The best intel in a place like this comes from the people. Keep your ears open.
But the people here, you know, they're kind of down on their luck. Like I remember, I mentioned humans have occupied 700-800 planets in the Halo universe, but each of them, most of those planets only have one or two little cities on them, and a lot of them look like this, you know. Like when we say we've inhabited 700-800 planets, it's not that impressive. I mean, it is impressive, sure, to our standards now, but to them in the future, we've only fully conquered Earth and Reach, and Reach is gone now. So this is what most other planets look like. So that's why I like kind of visiting other planets in this game. We visit this planet Meridian, and we also go to the Sangili homeworld, and we talk to the Arbiter. So it's cool to see the homeworld of them as well. Trying to get a mood pick, but it's all swollen and bloody. When I get it cleaned up, I'll post a pic. Yeah, no problem, dude. Yeah, take your time. New tattoo? Dope. Need to get one myself, Houston says. Oh, yeah. Hashtag Puminati tattoo.
I've never seen a glass planet in person before. It's kind of pretty.
Yeah. Got a weird idea of pretty. Meridian, by the way,
was on the other side of a knob
is glassed.
Survived the blast easy.
So this is what's left of Meridian.
Debris gets thrown into the atmosphere, blocks out the sun. Instant ice age for the whole world.
I like these.
That's a bit less easy.
Explanation, like, and that's the one thing this game does really well too. Is it? Just me. It adds to the universe of Halo.
I heard we got hit here and hopped a mongoose back. Right as I left, that ship flew past in the other direction, real low.
What was its bearing?
Going toward the station. It's going fast.
So it does show you like you life on other planets. It shows you what, you know.
UNSC. It's not my problem if your buddies didn't tell you where they parked.
Had to step away for a second. Time for dessert. Oh, that's right. Balazar ordered pizza tonight. I'm so jealous.
Sounds like it was a UNSC ship.
Yum yum yum. But yeah, that's one of the things I like in this game that they did. It's like normally, like I said, like with Resident Evil 6, we go to all these different locations, and I feel like it doesn't really do much for the story overall. You know, like not really. It gives it cool set pieces, which is great, but it's just so all over the place in a way. Whereas this, it does visit quite a few places, but it does show you a window into this universe, something that we've really only seen in extended universe stuff.
Hello.
And I thought they did a good job here with this. Sure, buddy. Let's go talk to this person.
What happened over at the comms tower, Ed?
A station signal was coming through. Distress call.
I love these guys' armor.
And the tower caught fire.
Okay, Ed,
that's cool, but this one's really cool.
Your painkillers should kick in soon.
It's mostly the colors, but he's got a different helmet on, too.
then screens.
Pretty neat looking.
And nothing.
All right, I'm gonna get a drink.
We might be able to help. Where was that transmission sent from?
UNSC swooping down to take our claim. I'll tell you what. Our folks at Apogee are plenty strong. Don't think you vultures can pick the bone so fast.
Yeah, so these guys don't like us too much.
I think that's our location.
So Apogee came under attack, and then a UNSC ship was seen heading that way.
Find a network terminal. I want to know more about Apogee.
What's everybody drinking tonight? Ooh, great question, Jamali. I felt that no one was intimidated by the Spartans anymore in Halo 5. No, they're not. They're not. Because the Spartans aren't... they're not special anymore to an extent. I talked about that a little earlier. Where Spartan 2s, obviously, they were stolen children that were trained since youth to become the ultimate weapons, and then they were also injected with super soldier serums, all this other stuff. Now, literally, you can make a Spartan with just like some excessive training, a syringe, and some armor. And that's where Sarah Palmer comes in. That's where all these Spartans come in. Buck, you know him. He was an ODST member. Now he's a Spartan. So obviously he wasn't trained since birth. If you watch the Nightfall movie, Spartan Locke wasn't trained since birth. So there is some specialness that has been taken away. Now, if Master Chief came through here and said, hey, I'm looking for this thing, some people might show a little bit of respect. But for characters like these guys, no. And we're just starting to get around of what we're doing here. And so on top of them just naturally not liking us because they're like, oh, you're UNSC, you're coming into swoop. It's much like how the, if you watch the Nightfall movie, how the planet that they're on, how they feel about Oni, which is what Spartan Locke was before he became ODST. I mean, before he became Spartan, he was Oni.
Accessing terminal.
And they felt the same way. So Spartan Locke is used to, he's used to it by now. But you're right. In this one, not a lot of love for Spartans. Even when we go to the Sangheili homeworld, they're not really impressed by us. We're not demons to them. Only Master Chief is. So there's a level of respect, kind of. Like no one's gonna punch us or throw tomatoes at us. But they are gonna not go out of their way to help us either. But that's also because word starts to travel on what our mission is. And so that makes us unliked even more. All right, heading to the Pelican. So we got our location, we know where to go, and we heading on out. Guinness and Shiner, Texas Black and Tan. Damn, eat feet. You were really numbing the pain of that tattoo. That's awesome, dude.
Boarding the Pelican.
Yeah, John Lee says, well done. I agree. So Balazar asks, are the Spartan 3s and on still crazy tall like Chief? Oh, yes. If you remember when in Halo 4, when Sarah Palmer meets Master Chief, she goes, huh, I thought he'd be taller. And then when you see her stand next to Lasky, she's like a good foot in almost foot and a half taller than Lasky. So yeah, they're still enhanced. The enhancement process is just easier. Imagine you look at Master Chief, you got to look at him like Captain America in a way, right? He's like an oddity in the program. He adapted to it better than anyone and is a natural leader and soldier. The rest of these people aren't that. So they're enhanced with the, so now they're making Captain America's left and right. So they all have the attributes of a Captain America. They're strong, they're tall, they have badass armor. So they all match Master Chief from a physical standpoint, but they still aren't Master Chief. So that's what still makes Master Chief stand out in this game as someone to be a force to be reckoned with and a force to be respected because he has saved the world numerous times. And like I said, he stood up against a Forerunner and lived. Even though he didn't take it down single-handedly, He did survive the experience, and that is grounds enough to be respected from a lot of people. Houston says PBR and a rare beer. I'm a Shuddy Boy. Nice. Seattle represent. What up? Shout out to Shuddy Boy, too, and Kevin Kraft. Miss those guys.
Open fire. Shoot everything.
I am looking where I'm shooting. You gotta look where you're walking, yo. You guys aren't fucking around. When in doubt, throw all your grenades. Oh, you're going down, bitch.
Who's next?
Whoo! Beer Brewery, PDG. Nice, Spacefly. I'm here because Joe after work. Oh, what's up? CB Nuttree, dude. What is up? Well, welcome, and thank you, Joe, for bringing the people over. Is Joe after work in here now, too? Were you guys streaming over there? Joe, what were you playing? Were you playing more Resident Evil 7? Hey, CB, welcome. Yeah, welcome, dude. The After Work crew is here. Nice. Thank you guys for coming over. Hi, CB. My name is Seek. Like, hi, didn't go Seek. And you are now officially a member of the Destroyers. You can still be an After Crew member as well, though, for sure. Everyone say hey to CB. Everyone's already doing that. Nice. If you like Ari, sir. Oh, Joe, what up? Damn right, good sir. Nice, man. Good to see you. Moobot, thank you very much. LOL. Hey, Joe, After Work. Seek is a good dude. You won't be disappointed, CB. Aw, thank you, guys. Well, any friend of Joe's a friend of mine. And you definitely get the warm welcome, for sure.
A lot of money going into this.
Thank you, Joe, for bringing the After Work crew over. Appreciate you, bud. Joe dog! Resident Evil 7 and went into Resident Evil Revelations on 3DS. Oh, nice! I gotta check that out. When, I'll watch it on your videos. I probably won't even wait until... I'll watch it on YouTube, too, probably, but... Don't even think about it. Well, before I streamed this, I actually had a bunch of Resident Evil 7 theories, and I didn't want to, like, wait to make a video for them, like a full video. So we did I basically played Resident Evil 6 for like an hour and just said all of my theories based on all the information that came out, based on watching Joe play the demo earlier. So I got all that out. If you guys want to check that out, it's in my archives right now, but I'll also put it on an edited version on my YouTube channel later. My dang Paras just fainted, bro. Forgot about the poisoning in his game. You were right, nightmares, bro. Oh my God, yeah, yeah. For sure. Don't forget the Pokerus.
All clear.
Oh, what's up, Ariel? Welcome, dude. Ariel was in here earlier too, which was super dope. Thank you guys for all being here. I really appreciate you. 13 people in the chat. Everyone, show the After Crew crew some love. Definitely give them a shout out. Say hello to them. They're good people. I love watching Joe's streams. They're always awesome people in there. And thank you guys earlier for coming to Joe's stream with me to watch him play the Resident Evil 7 demo. That was super awesome.
Found an access point.
Joe after work, talking nonsense. I love it. Seek theories. Yes, I had a lot of theories, and I'm not going to get into them now because we're kind of in Halo mode now, and I basically did that stream so I could get it all out of my system. I had so much to say about Resident Evil 7, and I got some theories that might blow your minds. So definitely check that out, either here on YouTube later. Dessert was good. Sugar Rush, Balazar said, nice. Nice, nice. CB says, I'm playing Pokemon Yellow. I forgot about how hard Pokemon could be. Oh, that's what you were talking about. Gotcha. Gotcha. Oh, yeah. The last Pokemon game I played was Red and Blue. but I remember when Yellow came out. Everyone was freaking out. But I that's how long it's been. Because I was like 17 or something like that. 16 or 17 when Red and Blue came out. All right. Let's get this party started. So we were playing Halo 5. I'll give you guys a little bit of a backstory on this in a second. Joe says, dude, thank you. Friggin', that was amazing of you. Oh, dude, no problem. We loved it, man. Yes, about Halo right now. We'll get into it for sure. Yes and no, I mean, I get all three main starters. Ah, okay. It was so fun to be on your stream, Joe. It really was, dude. CB says that helps, especially Koga. Ariel says, nice. Nice. Dude, Red Blue, I was 13 when that released. Oh, nice. So we're pretty close in age. That's pretty cool. Yeah, I think it was like 16 or 17. But yeah, that was my jam back then. Oh, shit. Oh, damn. CB says, oh. Space Fox Joe, are you drinking on that Tang and Jack? Oh, yeah. What's everyone drinking tonight? Let us know in the chat. Let us know if you're getting tore up. Ain't no judgments here. I think Joe's going to probably make me do my DMX impression, though, since he did his earlier. He was cracking me up with it. So I'll probably do mine at some point here soon. I got to get in the mood. So I'll build up to it, and I'll surprise y'all with it. And by the way, I'm at 92 followers on here. I've been on Twitch for about 3 months now. So we've been growing pretty quickly. So I made a deal that if we hit 100 followers, or when we hit 100 followers, I will play a game for 1 hour as DMX, which is totally going to fuck up my throat. But we got to do something to celebrate 100, so that's what we going to do, yo. Did you get to finish Walking Dead, Ariel asks. We only played the first level just for my mom's birthday. My mom had to go to work, so we only planned on playing the first level. So that's as far as we got. And then after that, I took an hour off, and then I recorded the Resident Evil episode, and then took an hour off and came back here for Halo 5. It's Seattle Beer Company. I live up in that area. Nice. Yeah, that's right. Got a couple Seattle folks in the house. Nice. Joe says, damn, I wasn't hungover until you just said that, LOL. Ariel says, I was 8 when Pokemon Red and Blue came out. Oh, my goodness. That's okay. Everyone's welcome here. No age discrimination. Faux show. Seek, oh, my God, yes, DMX, what? Oh, I'll get there, I'll get there. Hold on, let me get something to drink real quick. It really does a number on my throat. But this, Jomaly, get ready to laugh your ass off. Jomaly loves when I do DMX. CB said, oh my God, best idea ever.
X gonna give it to ya. Y'all motherfuckers be tripping. Arr, motherfucker. Y'all don't know the dog. Dog is the truth. Where the hood at? Where the hood at?
Cider, please. Ariel's laughing. Oh my God. Oh my God, Joe says. Cider, please send some. I agree, CB. That was a little sample. I'll get into some more later. That really fucked up my throat, though.
Watch your head.
Seriously, the last time I did it when we played Halo 4, I think I did it for like 10 minutes, and I could barely talk the next day at work. It was hilarious. All right. Christ Almighty on a fucking bike. Yeah, I've been listening to some of his CDs so I can get some of his lines and lyrics like down.
Only I can stop the rain. Only I can stop the rain. Only I can stop the pain. Lord, hear me.
I only have eyes for Joe after work. Oh man, I feel you on that one. I do too. Joe is mighty fine. Joe and I met in San Francisco, the city of love. Yes, city of Resident Evil now, because we got flown up there by Capcom, and that's how I met Joe. And actually, my interaction with Joe is what made me end up creating a Twitch account. Was because I wanted to meet more people like Joe. I wanted to meet other Resident Evil fans, other Halo fans. I'm a big Halo fan, obviously. But I'm also a writer. I write comic books. I write novels. And so I play things from a writer standpoint. You know, I dissect things from a writer standpoint. And so I play games for story. So you don't typically see me play games on hard or, you know, anything like that. Although I've beaten all the Halos on Legendary, you won't see me probably do them on the stream. Because I like keeping things simple. I like keeping up with the chat. and it's hard for me to do when the game's difficult, you know? So I like chatting with you guys. I like keeping up with y'all. So hopefully that's okay. Spaceflex says, LOL, okay, in the other room doing his impression. I think Detroit is brotherly love. Well, Detroit's brotherly love, yes, but I just meant love in general. For San Fran. LOL, Spacefly. Not, CB says, not eyes, love. Oh, you have love, okay. Used to be just a heart, LOL. Now for me, it's a monkey with hard eyes. Nice, okay, I got you, CB. I got you. I got what you're putting. I'm picking up what you're putting down. Oh shoot, he had ammo, yo. Or is that Philly? I think Philly is. Yeah, I think Philly's brotherly love. Yeah, I don't think Detroit's not that. Oh yeah, boom! Rip that head open. Oh shit. You know he ain't gonna be in Rush Hour 3. I'm from the suburbs, so I gotta get into some of my suburb sayings here in a second. John Malley loves those. Oh shit. Ow, 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 ow.
Come at me, dog! Ow, ow! Don't fuck with me! Rough Riders! Ride or die!
Oh, yeah. You had to say Philly. Space Fly, okay, oh my god. Detroit is the land of familial hate. Seek suburb sayings, yeah. I think everyone's favorite so far has been, what did I say? I'm gonna toss you like yesterday's salad. Everyone's like, what? I'm like, what? That's not a saying? Guys, quick PSA. Our buddy Seek here from the suburbs. Thank you. Thank you, Jamali. means he's not up to date on the new saying. I'm not up to date on old sayings. I think I'm up to date on fictitious sayings. I wouldn't even say I'm up to date on fictitious sayings. I just say them. Die. There you go. Good boy. Suck it, Trebek. Oof. Let's take whatever you are. Also means he makes up weird sayings. Just means he's from the suburbs. Wait, see, you're from the Detroit area? Yes. Isn't it obvious? I know. I must sound like it.
Area's clear. Move into the structure.
Joe's, it's okay, see, I lived in Staten Island for 10 years. I don't know what that means. Is that a suburb joke? I grew up all over the place. I actually did, you know, live in poor areas too and suburb-y areas. So I've had a mixture of both, what to be fair.
You know, we've seen
Sucker Trebek, great quote. I know, that's one of my favorites. I say it a lot. Uh-oh, Trebek is taking the heat again. I know, sure. It's time to drop a deuce on Trebek. How would it be obvious to me? I'm from Kansas. I don't know anything about Detroit. Oh, okay. Well, I didn't know. I was making a joke about my dialect. Like, I just assume I sound like the whitest fucking guy on the planet. Like, I'm not very good at it. I don't sound like I'm from any street. I think I grew up on a street, but not these streets.
Something here.
Staten Island is a borough in New York, but the area I was in is burbs. I'm by no means hard like DMX. Oh, gotcha. Well, I knew where Staten Island was, but I didn't understand that part of it, you know, that it was, I guess that makes sense geographically. That it's just more of a suburby kind of thing. Yeah, I mean, I've been to New York a couple times, but I'm not really, you know, I'm in LA, so I'm one of those kind of douchebags. Like nothing else outside of LA exists kind of douchebags. Even though I know that's not true and I don't act like it, it's just a funny joke more than anything. I'm from Kansas. I am the whitest guy in the world. CB, you're okay with me, man. Be as white as you want. Y'all, I'm 50% like DMX, John Lee says. I'm more like the fedora wearing Run DMC, Spaceflight says. I lived in L.A. Oh, yeah. Well, I'll be honest with you. I battled some depression out here, too. Like, and I don't mean to say that in a light way. Like, clinical depression for 2 years. Still struggle with it a little bit, but I got to say, changing my career in life, like I used to just work comics and I worked at home and it really, you know, added to my depression, not getting a lot of human interaction, except for making phone calls every month for, you know, retailers, trying to get comic book stores to order our books. Now I work at Lego. I work at one of their stores. I get a lot of human interaction now. I'm on Twitch. I'm on YouTube more. So it's like I've changed that, you know, and it's like, and that's definitely pulled me out onto the other side of depression for sure. So hopefully you're not battling it anymore either, bud. I know depression never fully goes away, but hopefully where you're living now has been helping you out. Joe says, John Malee, Joe, after work. What up? What up? Hey, Joe, did you look up my voice acting buddy? Yeah, Joe, did you?
He calls the guardian.
Better say yes.
To serve.
What was that?
Oh, yeah. So here's a new...
Move.
All right, so a little backstory for you guys. Seek, I appreciate that. I was an actor for 6.5 years, worked out of L.A. area. It was rough. Yeah, my buddy out here, Victor, he moved out here about 5 years ago to do the same thing, to act, and he's had a rough time too. And he works at the post office now, which I'm like, hey, I don't look down on any. I'm not too good for any job, but I know the frustration, you know, when you feel like you're not reaching your potential, or when people don't see in you what you see in you. I totally get that, man. So hopefully life is a little bit easier on you now. And I make stop motion Lego movies all the time, so I'm gonna start doing more of them soon. So if you want to do some voice acting, follow me on here and message me your email. Maybe I'll give you a shout out, and maybe you can do a voice in one of my next stop motion Lego movies. So let me know, brother. Yeah. Joe, did you? Balazar said, yeah, Joe. Exposed. Oh, exposed video on Joe after work. I'm trying to find his name in the chat, lol. A buddy of mine voiced one of the Boston Titanfall 2. Ooh, nice. Yeah, my neighbor, she's actually a voice actress. And she's done voices for Diablo 3.
Defend yourself.
And she also did, she was on Arrow the other day, which is pretty dope. She was on the 100th episode of Arrow. So this is the Warden.
Nice strike.
And he can eat shit. Mick Wingard. Yes, found it. I worked for a nonprofit. It was a bit different in some ways, ironically. Nice. Mick was also an Arrow. Nice, dude. Sweet. Well, stay in touch, man. Follow me on here. I'll follow you back. And let's send sweet whispers to each other. And work something out and exchange stories. That would be awesome.
Cortana is connected to this guardian somehow, and that makes it the Master Chief's most likely target. We find it, we find him. Let's go.
All right, so little backstory here. Let's hang out here for just a second. Pause on the gameplay a little bit. So the storyline here, Master Chief, as you know, is the big staple of the Halo universe. After Halo 4, he lost the person he cared for the most, which was Cortana, his artificial intelligence. And Cortana, she, in her dying moments, she pulled out the humanity that was in Master Chief. Master Chief was kind of felt like a weapon in the first three Halo games. Didn't really have a lot of personality to him, except maybe crack a joke here or there, but in like a dry kind of way. So what happened was in Halo 4, the humanity of Master Chief got pulled out a little bit more. And Cortana reached the man inside, and her dying wish basically was saving the man inside of him. So at the end of the game, he stood changed from the events that happened.
Know what that means.
And so now it's 8 months later, Halo 5, Master Chief no longer is like, he goes on missions he still gets sent on missions, he follows orders, but he does deviate from those orders a lot. Now he has a reputation of not really listening, and he's following those emotions. And what happened is he gets a message from Cortana, who he believes is Cortana, and she says, come to the planet Meridian. Now, at the same time, this group here, the people we're playing as now, Spartan Locke, he's one, him and Buck, who is voiced by Nathan Fillion. We have Tanaka there and Vale here. The four of us are Fireteam Osiris. We are rising in the ranks as badasses in the Spartan 4 programs and proving ourselves. And one of the things we did at the beginning of this game is we took down a rogue Covenant member named Jewel. And Jewel kidnapped Halsey, Dr. Halsey, who created the Spartan program and who also created Cortana. And she was being used and tortured. Her arm was cut off, and she was in one of the torturing sessions to get information out of her. And Jewel used her to find new technologies, to find Promethean weapons and things that to grow Jewel's army. And Jewel is running around trying to paint himself as a prophet, getting rogue Covenant members to join him. And so imagine after the Empire fell, he's now trying to lead the First Order, if you want to look at it in those terms. And so Jewel, in the first level, we went, hunted him down, and killed him as the Fireteam Osiris. So we proved, without a shadow of a doubt, we are badasses right at the beginning of this game, and we saved Halsey. We brought her back to the UNSC Infinity spaceship, and which is led by Commander Lasky, who was our friend and Master Chief's friend from Halo 4, and their AI, which is Roland, and they are both trying to track down Cortana. And they found out that now Master Chief knows Cortana's alive, or might be alive, and she's on Meridian. So Master Chief has disobeyed direct order to stay away from this, and he's coming to Meridian. So now we, Team Osiris, have been ordered to come here and stop him. And we are now becoming one of the most hated groups in the UNSC because we are basically standing in the way of a legend. We are standing in front of Master Chief, and most people love and respect him. And we are just some, you know, new bucks rising up in the ranks, no pun intended. And now we are faced to be hated by all, but we are trying to follow our orders. And if you want to know the background on Commander Lasky, check out on Netflix the Forward Unto Dawn movie, live action movie, which is awesome. Also has Master Chief in it. Great movie. Check out Nightfall, Halo Nightfall, which is the origin of Spartan Locke, our main character, who, when his helmet comes off, you'll notice looks really familiar if you're a Netflix Marvel fan, because he is actually motion captured Mike Coulter, who plays Luke Cage, and that's who is Spartan Locke. So yeah, you can imagine Luke Cage going after Master Chief. It's definitely a good fight. And then now Master Chief has showed up, and we are in pursuit. So now it's a race. Who could get to where we're going first? And now Cortana, we just found out, the warden there, there is gonna be all these little prisons, these Forerunner installations, and these wardens are specialty knights from Promethean and Forerunner technology that are guarding certain locations. And Cortana has accessed them and triggered them to allow Master Chief to pass, but anyone else, they are ordered to kill them. Which is why when we play as Spartan Locke, we have to fight the wardens. When we play as Master Chief, he can walk right by them, some of them. So yeah, so now we have our interaction. This is like Leon and Chris a little bit meeting.
This is your one chance to come home peacefully.
Luke Cage was a very fun time, absolutely. Good time indeed. CB says, my Midorian is evolving. Ooh, Pokemon evolve. And sorry if I missed some of the chat there. I was going off on a rant. Oh shit. Kick his ass, Seabass. Okay, we sucker punched him. Oh, knee to the chest. Oh, shit. Oh. Seek info drops are the best. Aw, thanks, man. Sometimes I have too much in my head, and it's like eating Mexican food. I have to have verbal diarrhea all over you guys. Try to get that image out of your head now. Uh-oh. That's gonna shut down. He cracked our helmet. That's gonna shut down our armor if he pegs us with it. That's his new James Bond tech that shuts down armor. He's trying to take us in alive. We're not making it easy on him, though. And we used his own weapon against him. He can't pull the trigger now. Oh my god. Wow, Clara. Oh man, thanks for that mental picture, Seek. You're welcome, Jamali. Damn. And his team just stood there and watched him get his ass kicked.
damn it.
Mental image. I can't unsee this. Sorry, guys. Nice. Yep.
Don't like the looks of this.
Check this thing out.
Get out how they got in.
Go, run.
He just got his, Joseph, he just got his ass handed to him. He really did. He really did. And again, thank you all for being here tonight. If you want to follow me on Instagram, it's the only social media I have. It's just at Seek and Destroy, S-I-I-K-E, and Destroy. You can also check out my website, SeekDonnelly, D-O-N-N-E-L-L-Y, .com. Definitely subscribe to my YouTube channels. I have a main channel, and I also have a gaming channel. You can look those up, YouTube.com/SeekDonnelly. Oh, nice. You're welcome, Buck. And if you follow me on here, I will follow you back. And if we hit 100 followers, then we will be playing an hour of a game. On the day we hit 100, we'll play an hour of a game, and I'll do DMX's voice as, hopefully for the whole hour. Hopefully I don't totally ruin my throat for the rest of my life, but either way, it'll be fun. Aw, thank you, Joe. Thanks for dropping the link. And by the way, all of you guys follow each other for sure. Everyone in here is super... Oh, Balazar, thank you. Thank you for the social command. And thank you, Joe, for the link. But make sure you guys are all following each other, too. Become besties. And if you guys stream, let each other know that you stream. Let me know that you stream. And I definitely want to check out some of your stuff as well. We had so much fun in Joe's stream earlier. Joe, by the way, did you get the journal to work? I was watching Where's Barry, and he was pointing the hand at things, and it was causing the journal, like words to appear in the journal. So I thought that was pretty cool.
Why is the chief on this guardian?
I don't stream. That's okay. I'll still follow you back, bud. Yes, I did, Joe said. Awesome. Did you finish it? Did you get all five of them? All five of the things you had to point at, Joe? Did you get a third ending, basically? Or is it just like extra fun stuff to do in the game? Oh yeah. Yes. I thought there were five because you got one. Oh yeah, there's multiples, dude. Multiples.
With or without you.
I believe there's five because it's, you know, the red writing. I couldn't figure out the rest, LOL, but I got two endings. Nice. Yeah, I want you to get the two endings, the true ending and the infected one. I don't know if getting all five unlocks, you know, another ending or not, but I was just kind of curious what they did. Ow. No, stop. Dude, you suck. That's not gonna work. All right, we're leaving. Oh shit, we're dead. Joe says, it seemed like there was room for more. I just couldn't figure out to save my life. Yeah, you gotta...
Broadcasting on all frequencies. People,
I was trying to figure out with Barry. I only saw Barry get two of them. I was trying to help him get them. You have to, like, walk by certain items, hear a giggle from the little girl. Death count one, by the way. That escalated quickly. Yes. Death count one, Balazar.
Watch it, they're on your tail.
Just in case you guys are wondering, our first death of the night. Bound to happen. Especially with my driving skills. Oh yeah, Prometheans know how to drive cars.
Got a hell of a singing voice.
Can we do autopilot retrieval? Bring the Pelican down to us.
Mayday, mayday! We're taking fire! We're hit!
Command, thank you. I'll figure it out, LOL. Yeah, I won't spoil anything for you. But you just gotta find, you gotta walk around and look for items that make a giggle happen, and then the giggle shows you an item and that hints at something and, you know, unlocks another passage in the journal or something like that, yeah. But you do have to use the dummy hand to point at things. So it looks like there is a purpose for that thing, and it is a little supernatural, which is interesting. And speaking of supernatural things, I definitely drop a lot of my theories on those elements in the in my video as well.
Governor Sloan, we need access to the space elevator.
All right, here we go.
That, Spartans. Got too many people taking refuge inside. They'd be slaughtered.
Understood, Governor.
Seek driving skills have been dismissed. That's some Silent Hill shit right there. CB is it not in the window store? Oh, that must be from another conversation. Hey, buddy. Guess what? I want your gun. Shit. What are you doing? Where are you? No, nothing? Okay.
Continue the search. Slipping out of ambush.
Whoa. I hear it. Where is it at? I heard it like swearing or something. There was like a creature back here or something. They put a free multiplayer version of Halo 5 in the store, but they aren't putting the campaign on PC. Oh, I see. Gotcha. Yeah, I must have missed that. Sorry about that. Ah, okay. So I got multiplayer on there. Yeah. Multiplayer's kind of fun. I'll be honest, though, I haven't really given it a strong chance. I played a little bit of it, but didn't really give it a good chance. Arrow says, hello, Joe. I'm watching one of our vids where you fought the totem wishy-washy, a.k.a. Dragon Ball Fusion. Nice. Yeah, sometimes I just go back and I just watch random Joe videos too. Some people call it stalking. I call it being best friends from a distance. I call it a precursor to Misery. The movie. Joe says, Seek, playing that game in PSVR is fun, to say the least. Oh my god, yeah, I don't know about that. I'm kind of glad I don't have a PS4 and a VR setup, because I don't want... my first playthrough of Resident Evil 7, I don't want it to be me throwing up everywhere. Although, that would make a fun stream, so maybe. Joe says, I agree! The multiplayer on PC, though, is so bare bones, it only works if you have a lot of friends and some basic coding skills set up your match. Kind of embarrassing. Oh yeah, I know. For sure. They did. There is definitely some things they dropped the ball on in this game. Houston and I were talking about that earlier. Arrow says, I'm all good. Well, not the misery part. Best friends from a distance is a perfect relationship. I agree. That would go viral, Justice.
So,
yeah, so Sloan, the mayor, now is losing his mind. He's given into rampancy, and he's now following Cortana in a way, but he's also still kind of helpful to an extent as well. He's opened up all the doors for us, which is nice.
Between us and the Pelican,
weapons free.
I'd watch even if you threw up. Aw, thanks, Spacefly. By the way, Spacefly and OK Cunning, I've had some fun streams with them recently, which has been great.
Let's clear the ladies to workspace, shall we?
They were playing games like Party Hard, which I had no idea was a game that existed, and it was funny as hell. Spacefly had some great one-liners in there, too. OK Cunning and Spacefly were playing No Man's Sky the other day, which I found pretty interesting. My favorite part about it, though, was that she built a cute boy's room, which was pretty funny. She said something, and I was like, because I was so tired. It was like 2 in the morning or whatever whatever it was. And I was like, ooh, a cute boy's room. What's that? Best friends from a distance and A-Hole Productions. Nice. Just beat the super nerd. Which fossil should I take? CB wants to know, Joe. Let him know. Helix, all hail Ammonite. Nice. You dapper bastard. Okay. Oh, it's underneath us. I was like, it's around here somewhere. I think I'll be going with the dome then. Oh, God. Oh, Lord. Wait, OK Cunning streaming? Where the hell was I? It was like you were in bed. like a human being would be. I had problems powering down for the night as a robot. Wouldn't that be awesome if I get a Kinect and you guys actually see my face and it's actually I'm just a digital creation. And I fake all my Instagram posts and. Well, Joe know that Joe and Jomley, they may say that that's not true because they've met me in real life, but any other fire team I have a stand-in.
They're family.
Exactly.
Don't know. Where were you, Joe? Okay, because RIP Cute Boys room. We lost it when the game crashed. Aw, the game crashed. Bummer. Damn it. Okay. Robot confirmed. Oh my God. Yeah, it was funny watching just the sidestep on Resident Evil stuff for a minute. Whereas Barry was making the joke that Avid Expert would say zombie confirmed, and sure as shit, Avid Expert made a video today that was like subtitled or it had on the thumbnail, zombie confirmed. I'm like, there was no zombie confirmed. What are you talking about? That is what humans look like before they turn into molded in Resident Evil 6 or 7. That is not a zombie. Guys, I don't know if I met what I met Seek or was a surrogate. Yeah, it was my surrogate. Joe says, Space Fight, damn, that sucks. So I don't know, y'all. His surrogate has a nice smile, but it could be the smile of a liar. Well, yeah, it's a surrogate. I mean, come on. Of course it lies. It's full of liar smiles and wishy thinking. All right, we got more Prometheans. Here we go. Joe says Seek is actually the elusive man from Mass Effect. No, you give me too much credit. Too much credit. But I'm going to give myself more credit. I'm Dr. Doom. And what you met was a Doombot. Where did you get your surrogate, Seek? I need a couple. They're Doombots. I got them in Latveria where I built them. With my awesome superior tech. Superior to that hack Reed Richards, anyway. It should know better than wishy thinking. I also need a couple of Seek surrogates. I'm not taking questions. Jomley. Oh my goodness. You're the height of too muchery. Oh, there's another asshole up there with a one of these good guns. Come on down, Cletus. Ooh. Blew his head off. I think you're the doctor, period. The doctor from Doctor Who, and you're streaming from your TARDIS. I'm probably more like Jack from Torchwood. Governor Sloan isn't here. But that's a nice compliment, though. Thank you. Playing all the Halo games in order like this really helps keep the story straight. Don't think I ever didn't like Halo, but your streams sure renew my love for it. Aw, thanks, man. Yeah, I love Resident Evil. Resident Evil is, I would say, my top favorite video game series. But I would say there is evidence to suggest that I'm lying about that because I don't have a Resident Evil tattoo, although I thought of getting a couple. I just, I couldn't make them look interesting, you know? And so I did get that Halo ODST symbol there. So I have the Halo ODST symbol and one of the glyphs tattooed on my arm. But I do love both franchises very much. And my hope is to make people, you know, so just to show people why I love it. Not so much like change anyone's mind or opinions if they don't like it, but just to explain why I like it, you know? Why Jack? Because he's kind of weird. He's like a different animal every day. Some days he's like over the top. Some days he's, you know, I don't know. Like, I don't know. I just love that character. I actually started watching Doctor Who and then Jack showed up on it. And then I ditched Doctor Who and started watching Torchwood. And I never went back to Doctor Who. I don't know, I like that character. I like John Barrowman. I think he's a good actor. I like him on Arrow, too. I think he's one of the best parts about Arrow. I made it to Cerulean. Ooh, nice, CB. Joe after work. John, are you asking questions? LOL. God, I forgot how much of an accomplishment this game is. It really is. Visually, this game is quite stunning. No questions, John Lee says. In your face, in la cara.
Everyone all right?
Sorry, just watching that vid. Nice, Ariel. Barman is an amazing actor, no questioning that. Yeah. So I think I kind of, it's more like wishing. I wish I was as cool as Jack. So I'm just going to say that I'm as cool as Jack.
Run a scan. Find an exit.
Find me an exit, fucker. Here we go. But again,
there's
thank you all for being here tonight.
Moving towards the Pelican.
Nice making new friends too. CB, you're awesome. Ariel, thank you for being around today too.
More than you want it to be.
Love both your faces. And thank you, by the way, for the follow, CB. I appreciate that, and I will definitely follow you back. You're my 93rd follower on here. And like I said, when we get to 100, we will definitely have a night of DMXing for y'all. Maybe I'll even try to hook up my Groove account on my Xbox here and play some DMX music. So we'll just get copyright infringed upon like a motherfucker. Rough Riders don't care about copyright shit. Yes, now for the murderous road to Bill. but nope. Oh, by the way, Joe, when's the next stream? Yes, Joe, let us know. Where are we going? Where the hood at, dogs? Damn, see, you just got hyped. Can you go BMXing instead? I'll be honest with you, not so good at that. I know, surprising, right? Oh, you fucking... You don't get it, yo. X just gave it to you. All right, we need the Spartan laser. Oh, you got hit. I thought Phil shakes. Yeah. Oh, shit, missed. Only one shot left. And I missed. Let's get one of these going. Ooh, what's up, rocket launcher? You gonna like that shit. I'm gonna put my dick in. I'm gonna put my dick in. Oh, shit. Where were you my whole life? Yeah, you dead. PS2 hype? Dave Mirra's BMX while playing DMX. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, will the meta-ness never end? The layers, the jokes, I love it. I fucking love it, dog. BRB will have headphones, but I'm away from the keyboard. Don't say weird shit. Well, I feel like I kind of have to now. Hey, Moobot, what's up? Weird shit being said right now. What do you mean weird shit? Like, this is my first abortion? You mean don't say stuff like that? I shouted that out for some context for you guys. When I played South Park Stick of Truth, it was my first time playing it. And I yelled that out on the abortion scene. And it broke my little SJW heart to cross that line. But sometimes you got to do things for humor. And so we did. This is the first hypothetical abortion stream, Joe says. yep, all hypothetical. No, I like you. We're gonna keep this rifle though. We gotta destroy those guys first. Those things suck. And the Watchers, and they revive enemies too. Yeah. Nice. Is it horrible that I'm not an SJW? No, dude. You be who you are, man. As long as you have fun in here and everyone else having fun, that's all I care about, dude. And I don't really go full SJW anyway in here. I've kind of toned that shit down, actually. I realize how alienating it is to people, and I don't want to be like that. I don't want to alienate anyone. I want everyone to have a good time, you know? So yeah, you won't see me go on any tirades or nothing like that. We're just here to have fun. We live in fictional worlds on my channel. We leave all of our baggage and our real-world bullshit, we leave that all at the door, and we just come here and have fun. So if that's your speed, if that's your cup of tea, then drink up, motherfucker! It was more like a colonoscopy. It was. And I was awful at it. I was still awful at it. I just got a visual, Joe said. Nice. Seeks chill. Ah, thanks, Joe. SJW equals social justice warrior? Yes. Yes, it does. Yes, it does.
Just outside. Move it, people.
Oh, shit.
Shockwaves are getting closer together. Almost like a countdown.
What happens when it gets to zero?
I don't want to find out.
Look at this thing.
Get to the Pelican.
So this is that creature that awoke down underground.
Everyone, on board, now.
When we were chasing after Master Chief, we got left behind with it. Master Chief took that portal and got away. And we took the portal he came in on and left. And we're up here taking the Pelican. And this Guardian has been awakened by Cortana and, you know, or assuming Cortana. Drinking confirmed. Oh yeah, I knew that, Dowser said. Nice. I'm Libertarian, LOL. Pretty much a warrior for people saving, leaving me alone. Nice. That's cool. But yeah, my friend Daniel is Libertarian. One of my good friends, Daniel, from back in the day. One of the guys who, him and my friend Tom got me into Halo. So it's all good, man. As long as you can have fun with us, you're okay. You're a member of the Destroyers now. You follow me, I follow you back, brother. And now you're a member of the after work crew and the Destroyers. Look how gorgeous this is, man. I love the Guardians. They look awesome. Spacefly says I'm an innocent bystander. CB says I'm loving the stream a lot. Oh, dude, thank you. Appreciate that, man. Well, anytime my streams are this good, it's because of the chat and the people in it. So if you're having a good time, you pat yourself on the back. Pat yourself on the balls, because you guys are making it fun. And I second what Balazar said. He said, glad to have you here, CB.
It's 11 colonies.
Oh, show.
I need a means to stop this now.
This is some Zone of the Enders fucking shit right here. Holy hell. It is, man. Those things very much look like the Enders.
Not yet.
Good call. Space Slice says no one is safe. I got welcomed by like five people right away. Hell yeah, dude. Because that's how we roll around here. The name the Destroyers is kind of intimidating maybe, but we use it ironically.
That's because they haven't heard my great idea.
But Joe says ball pats. Hashtag ball pats.
That noise is an encoded
numerical. Alright, here we go. We got some information here. I'm going to chill out for a second. Get a drink.
Coordinates for a forerunner map.
If Locke's team could feed the Guardian the coordinates recorded on Meridian, it would take them to the same place Cortana took Master Chief. Tom, we can stop this.
We all family. Welcome to the family, son. Hashtag Puminati. Oh, we're going to the Sangili homeworld. Okay, the second I step away from the computer right here, I'm going to put my dick in, and this is my first abortion. I'm going to put my dick in as a soundbite that they use a lot on Mad Scientist Party Hour, which is a podcast that I frequent, which is how Houston knows me. If you guys check it out, it's at Riotcast, RIOTCAST, riotcast.com/Mad Scientist. My friends Shuddy Boy and Kevin Kraft are the ones who are on the podcast, and they have me and my friend Alex on from time to time. It's a lot of fun.
What's Cortana up to, Chief?
And they talk about a lot of crazy shit.
Why'd
on
she
there.
Bring us here?
And Kevin has a YouTube channel, which is really
Let's
fun, called Kevin Does Stuff. And he does everything while on drugs, basically. He gets high and he like opens loot crate boxes and gaming boxes, and he gets high and plays video games. He's a big Nintendo fan, so he plays a lot of Nintendo stuff on his Wii U and stuff. It's pretty funny stuff, actually.
No comm traffic on any
CB says, Joe, after work, I just defeated Gary and Cerulean. Didn't take a single HP damage. I'm like, dang, man. CB dropping the hammer down over there. Look at this level, too. So this planet of Sangili, the Sangilian homeworld, they went really alien with it. I mean, it has basic structures like rock formations and stuff like that, but their trees are like shaped like they're like stone-ish and twirl around like trees, like you see there. I mean, they went alien with this world, which I like. And this Guardian is popping around different planets, you know, taking down, taking information on each world. So we're going to learn, like, you know, we have to get in contact with the UNSC, and they're going to tell us to pop in coordinates into the Guardian, and it's going to take us Console to where Master Chief is. Oh, I'm sorry. I apologize. I forgot we switched. We are Master Chief right now. We came with a Guardian. There's another Guardian back where the Team Osiris is. And if they feed instructions into it, it'll basically pin, open a portal right to us. So right now we have switched to Master Chief. Oh my God, I don't know if I let anyone film me while I was high, even just to open Loot Crate. I know, right? This dude's dope. Yeah, Kevin's good people, man. Kevin's good people. All right, Puminati, hashtag MSPH. I'd post all the links, but this is from my phone, so yeah, it's all good. Just check out Riotcast, R-I-O-T. Cast, C-A-S-T, riotcast.com/madscientist, and you'll find them. Or you can look them up on iTunes, Mad Scientist Party Hour. It's a good time, I promise. I forgot he showed up when you headed for Nugget Bridge. Oh, okay, Pokemon stuff. I was like, Nugget Bridge? We're not. There's no Nugget Bridge on this planet.
She's out there somewhere.
So I'm sorry. So this is not Sangili. Sorry. We will see the Sangili homeworld. I forgot it's. I'm getting the levels confused here. I apologize.
We'll learn what's going on.
So we're on a random planet that Cortana teleported us to. So we don't actually know where we are. But it is full of Forerunner technology, as you can see. But again, the trees kind of have these stone looks to them, like these, like they've almost like they've petrified, which I really like. And they have these big blossoming plants, and it's pretty neat. Little puddles of water. I just love how this game looks. Look at the ripples. It's just so damn good. Bowser says, speaking of Guardians, new Guardians of the Galaxy trailer. I need to watch it. Ooh, I need to watch it too. And I definitely need to check out the Telltale game when it comes out of Guardians. That's going to be dope. OK says it's awesome. Nice. CB says, I'm so glad you know all the lore to Halo. I know a ton. Now, I will be honest with you. Take some of the stuff, and I'll try to preface it when I'm not sure. Try to take some of the stuff with a grain of salt. It's a lot to remember because it's confusing. I've read a lot of the novels. I've read all the comic books from Dark Horse. I've played the video games. I've seen all the movies. But I still get stuff wrong, and I do blend things together in a wrong way, and I do misinterpret stuff sometimes. So take some of what I say with a grain of salt. I do make mistakes, but I do try to, you know, I do try to pride myself in the knowledge I do have of the universe, and I try to explain things so people have more fun, because sadly, these games, some of them are weak on explanation and exposition. And as much as I hate exposition, it is necessary. And some of these games give them off in the worst way. They give them through files. They give them through other ways of, you know, of not just playing. And I'm, as you notice, I'm skipping a lot of that information. So I'm trying to remember what some of these files say too, and reread them to you guys without actually having to go access them. So I do my best. That's for sure. But I appreciate you saying that, man, very much. I don't know any of it. My 12-year-old son knows way more than me. And that's the thing is I know some 13-year-old's going to come in here one day and go, actually, that's not true, you know, and I will stand corrected.
Ready up, blue team.
Oh, you dead. Oh, you dead. Homie, don't play that. I don't really play Halo console shooters, and my hands don't get along. I hear you. I hear you on that one. For sure. We're all humans, LOL. That's the glory of your streams. It's a lot more information than I would have ever known to begin with. Well, that's my thing. It's like, when I was looking at... I did a lot of research, actually, on Twitch streamers and what everyone does well and what I thought I could do well. And, you know, you kind of have to have a thing, you know, when you stream. That's what everyone says. They're like, oh, you want to grow your channel, kind of have a thing. Like, be the Halo guy, be the Resident Evil guy. But play other games, but always fall back on, like, two or three main franchises. So that's what I'm going to do. Resident Evil and Halo, we're going to play a lot. But, more, you know, hospitals. We will take months. You know, like, this month, we're going to be playing Batman Arkham Knight starting on Monday. So that'll be a lot of fun. I love Batman. I know a lot. I've been reading comics for almost 30 years now. So I will definitely blow you guys away with the shit I know about Batman. That's for sure. So I figured that would be my thing, you know? Like, I'll be the knowledge guy. I'll be the guy who drops knowledge, and if I get something wrong, I'll at least start a conversation with somebody who does know more. And that's kind of my hope. So I definitely try with that, for sure, man. I appreciate you saying that. The feels, Joe says. You mock me, CB says. Balazar, that trailer, holy hell. I gotta watch it. Will someone whisper me a link to the Guardians of the Galaxy trailer so I can watch it after we kick it? Because we might take a break. We might take a halfway point and take a break. Because I think we might finish this tonight. I don't know. We still have tomorrow to play, too, so... I want to save some gaming for tomorrow, because Monday night we're going to be playing Batman, Arkham Knight, which will be fun.
That'll do.
It helps to hear the backstory from someone who cares, too. Oh, nice. Well, I try to give as much as I can. Ballas says, oh, fuck yeah, it is. Just watch it. Man, I'm excited. Oh, I can't wait to see this. So good. I love Guardians. And actually, James Gunn was actually a guest on Mad Scientist Party Hour. So if you guys want to look for old Mad Scientist episodes when you go check them out on iTunes or at the website... Listen to the James Gunn episode. It's a lot of fun. Joe says to John Lee, 100% agree. Almost 30 years. Everyone gets off his lawn. Everyone get off his lawn. Yeah, for sure. Yeah. And as someone who's written comics, too, it's hard for me to read a lot of them now. I get very much grouchy old man, for sure. Because a lot of the books come out now, they're really good, but they're stories I've read a million times before. Because if you stick with anything for more than like 10 years, it starts repeating itself, you know? So yeah, that's for sure. Hey, Echo. Echo just joined us, everyone. I love how Joe after work doesn't even address my accusation. Clearly it's so true. Joe's hiding right now. Oh, shit. Oh, I gotta do the Richard Cheese. Oh, shit. A-ba-ba-ba-ba. Get up. Come on, get down with the sickness. You fucker, get up. Come on, get down with the dickness. Hey, Echo, Space Spy says. Aw. Echo says hello. He licked his balls, which means hello, I think. Still working on translating. But I think that's what it means. WM, thank you so much for hosting me. Appreciate you, bud. Mocking, you haven't seen me play FPS. Nice. Aw, Joe says, tonight was close enough. hey, Echo. Everyone says, hey, Echo. Echo, Echo in the house. Based on the 3DS RE, you're pretty leap. Dahal, is that song? Pretty leap. Complimenting Joe after work. Joe's awesome. Oh, snap. Oh, no. Gun empty. Oh, shit. Are you empty, too? Damn it. We're gonna die. We're gonna die. Oh, hoo-hoo. Made it. Damn, son. You've been stuck. You've been hit by. You've been struck by a smooth criminal. Eat shit. You've been. Oh, yeah. Always take out the biggest guy. Like this. Ooh. Richard Cheese, yo. Area that was clear. Seek and Destroy, Grammy nominee song. James Gunn, episode 67. iTunes, maybe SoundCloud? Yes. Like that's right. I think it was. It might be on SoundCloud. Assuming we're right, and I can't remember. I don't know if I've ever looked for them on SoundCloud. The possible, though. Pulled into slip space. Oh, need to learn the house. Could have ended up anywhere. Joe is that dude, for sure. Oh, yeah. For sure. Houston says, what was the name of the podcast again? It's Mad Scientist Party Hour. And you can find it on iTunes, or you can go to riotcast.com and check it out. They are. Check out this planet. Look how far we've run, that Guardian. All the way over there now. Nice. All right, let's do this. Where are we going? We gotta go up, yo. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna take a Forerunner gun. Yes.
Yes!
Heh. Ollie Ollie oxen free!
Signal again. Activate the console.
Seems like we're supposed to.
And if anyone is out there is into reading, you know, books and shit, that kind of nerdy shit, if you could only read one Halo book, I would recommend reading The Fall of Reach. It's actually really good. For those of you who want to know a little bit of the backstory, I know some, many of you have already heard this before, but for some of our new people, the backstory on the Spartans. So Dr. Halsey, who was the one-armed woman in this game, but she's the woman who created us. She also created Cortana. Yep, Seek said it. MSPH, Mad Science Party Hour. What's up, man? What's up, Knowledge? Knowledge in the house. Everyone say hello to Knowledge716. Welcome them to the chat. Yeah, Balazar already started. Nice. Thank you, Balazar. Everyone make Knowledge feel welcome. We could always use some more Knowledge around here. Welcome, 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 Knowledge. And if you have any to drop on us, feel free to do so. If you're a big Halo fan, let us know what your favorite Halo in the game in the franchise is. I always love hearing everyone's favorites. Everyone's, oh, look at that, all that love. Look at that, thank you guys for that. Appreciate you.
It's another one.
Knowledge is our 11th person in the stream tonight, which is awesome. 11 is my lucky number. It has not let me down yet. It's the number of my birthday too, May 11th, which is also the number of the T-Virus outbreak in Resident Evil 1. If you read the Keeper's Diary, if you read the Keeper's Diary, he talks about an outbreak happening on May 11th in the labs underneath the Resident Evil mansion. So 11 is a good number, right? Because it causes a zombie outbreak. That makes it good. CB says, I like Halo 1. It was on PC. Nice. ODST for days, Bowser said. Reach, says Joe after work. Nice. Love all of those answers. There's no wrong answer here. My birthday. Oh, excuse me. I had a little fucking burp. CB says, my birthday is September 22nd. Nice. 11 times 2. Love it. See, cause the outbreak. Well, you know, I am Dr. Doom after all. Bilbo and Frodo's birthday was also on September 22nd. Nice. BFFs, BFFs, heading off to Mordor.